How's it going, everyone? Dan here, and welcome back to some more. I forgot what game I was playing. Isaac Afterbirth Plus. I promise you, it is morning time now. Unlike yesterday's drowsy episode, I'm awake, and this time we're going to win. We lost this Maggie, but you know it was my fault for thinking that freaking piercing Dr. Fetus was going to be good because I forgot about that synergy. But it was either. It was either we were going to have piercing Dr. Fetus bombs, or we were going to have, ooh, that was actually a pretty good experimental treatment for the sacrifice and speed we just got. I'll take that trade 15 out of 10 every time. But, yeah. So, I definitely lost yesterday because of that. But it wasn't because of the synergy, just because bad play. Honestly, if I would have took the flying ability, it probably would have helped a little bit, but... It happened. It happens. I'm going to lose in Isaac. I'm not a god in Isaac. There are going to be losses, and I'm going to upload those losses, regardless of how bad they are. You know? I don't think I've not once scrapped an Isaac episode at all. I've always uploaded all of my losses, all of my fails, no matter how short they are, even if they happen within 2 seconds of the run. It always happens, and I always upload it. I won't hide nothing from you guys at all. The only things that I scrap are games that usually have recording issues, or games that usually... I usually don't find fun. Like, as I'm recording the first bit of it, I'll be like, this isn't fun, and I'll just stop. I'm not gonna scrap anything Isaac-related. I love this game too much. But, yeah, so I cut my elbow last night. And I feel like this desk, my computer desk, is a freaking safety hazard to my health right now. Because I've cut myself so many times on this desk, it's not even funny. I think I told you guys about it, but I cut my hands, or like my knuckles, in the same place, on both hands, doing the exact same action. And I was like, Jesus. I'm hurting myself too much, man. And now I cut my elbow, and it actually, drew blood. Jesus, I freaking started bleeding really badly. I don't know what's wrong with me and this desk, but something needs to change. That's a speed upgrade. No, it's not. I think that was last run the yellow pill was a speed upgrade. Right now, the yellow pill is an unknown. It's an uncertainty of what... Ooh! Not even close. Oh my god. Yeah, right now it's an uncertainty that will probably make us lose our Devil Doe chance, but it could just as easily guarantee our Devil Doe chance. But who cares about that right now? I just want to win. And right now, if I have to win through natural play without... What is this? Tonsils. Sure. If I have to win without getting carried, then that's what's going to happen. No more Dr. Fetus failures. We are going to win. Don't worry, boys. I promise you, I will win this run of your money back. Well, you didn't pay any money, but... You will get your time back. Guaranteed. Or your money back. Call right now and you will be able to get your... I will use a bomb for that. And I think I will take... Oh, you know what? No, I won't take Bible Tract. I don't know what Tonsil does just yet. If it's like a red... If it's just, Common Cold nerfed, then I don't really want it. But if it gives us some different tier that does more damage, I'll take it. But I haven't seen a difference yet. I don't know what this does. What could a tonsil do? Personally, I don't even know what tonsils even do in the human body at all. I thought I remember seeing a video that said tonsils are one of the parts of the human body that are actually completely useless now. Similar to like the tailbone and other things that have like... been left over from development or what's the word I'm looking for? Evolution, I guess. Whatever. Hell if I know. I'm very unknowledgeable. You guys know me. I'm just a dummy playing games. Oh, let's go! Jacob's Ladder. One of my most favorite Afterbirth Plus items. Guaranteed. This was paralysis. I'm fine with this. Dude, I love Jacob's Ladders. I bet everyone does too, but I love this item. I think by far, out of all the Afterbirth Plus items, this has got to be my favorite so far. Definitely. And it works so good when you can, like, just stand against a wall or a rock. And just shoot the wall. I think it would work really well with Parasite. If we can get it. That'd be pretty nice. Now, I still don't know if the lightning scales with damage, but if it does, then, we're a pretty good run here. I mean, it's already a pretty good run. We are pretty good on the old damage. Pretty low on the old speed, but, you know, we're used to playing Maggie with no speed. Let's wait on, Placenta right now. You know what? Let's go for Angel Rooms, guys. I ain't done this in a while. We're strong enough. We don't really need Guppy's Tail. We don't have keys, and we don't need the shovel. We're just gonna go for it. Good old Angel Room run. Let's see if RNGesus wants to forgive me for throwing away his good run yesterday. With some Angel Rooms, if we can get them. Not saying we won't get them. It's just seemingly unlikely that we will. But hope you guys are doing alright today. Like I said, we're doing pretty good. I'm actually excited for today for multiple reasons. One, gotta get caught up on Isaac so I can keep you guys in the flow. You guys, Isaac episodes are going, so I can get back on schedule with those. Two, gonna start the new series today to fill in the gap on the Let's Plays. And three, I think that's plenty enough good reason as is. It just feels like a good day today. We completed Dark Souls livestream yesterday. I was happy with the result. We didn't complete the game 100%, but now I gotta figure out a new game to play on the livestream, which... Actually, I might just go ahead and do the same thing for Dark Souls 3 and do a mage run of that game, because I know Dark Souls 3 forward and backwards now, just about, with Melee. Just like, I can beat that game with Melee, guaranteed. I know all the patterns just for the most part now. If I have the damage, I'm gonna win, but with the mage run, it might be a little bit different in Dark Souls 3. Experiencing that game, experiencing even Dark Souls 2 as a mage was shocking. You know, thinking I know, I have all the dodge timers down and then getting it handed to me, but then I realized that Dark Souls 2's dodge was actually a lot harder than Dark Souls 3's dodge. Because of the adaptability stat, you know, there was actually a stat for your dodge frames, and that was definitely a struggle. It was fun. It was fun. And since I don't really got any other games planned right now for the live stream, I guess I will go ahead and do Dark Souls 3 next week. Do we want to go to a shop? I guess we can. There's no reason not to. Are there normally restock machines in these shops? I mean, I don't think I've seen those very often. Starter deck. Yes. Why question starter deck? I don't know. And then we're gonna stay in here real quick. Cause I have a plan. You wanna know what the plan is? I don't have a plan. There never was a plan. Our plan is just get a bunch of money and or the blood bag, which will give us our speed upgrade back. And I will take it. Oh, or just don't. I mean, you cannot as well, which I mean is not a terrible plan, but... Wait, what? Why am I getting so much from this? Why am I getting two payouts from IV bag? Hello? I don't know what happened there, but I'm gonna buy this spirit heart and this card. Joker, alright, goodbye. And by goodbye, I mean literally it was a goodbye. I'm gonna restock the room real quick. We're most definitely gonna take Hive Mind out of the, you know, sheer fact that we might get what you call it later. And I'm gonna make a weird play. I'm gonna buy this and play it twice and hope we get more than 3 cents. Which we didn't. Which is not a shock, really. And now we have a Joker card. I think that shop turned out well. You know? We started out with the speed upgrade. The irony that we have no speed now is kind of weird. But you know what? I'm actually quite comfortable right now. We should fight the boss. There's a 50% chance. Oh, no. There's a 50% chance of this Devil Room being an Angel Room. Oh god, please don't. Oh, you bitch. You tricked me. I really hate Bighorn. He's so freaking tanky, man. What? I wanna do this stun thing. Pop up. So I can kick a bomb in your mouth. Damn it. Oh, I did it. Yay! Get ready. Oh, he takes more damage when you stun him. I didn't know that. Why'd y'all tell me that? I didn't know he takes more damage if you stun him like that. And you don't even have to kick it in his mouth. You just gotta blow him up while he's doing that animation. And then we get this. I don't want Headless Baby. I told you, Angel Rooms, we're doing it. We are one syringe away from Spun. Instead, we're gonna have a naturally strong run again. But you know what the downside is about having all this low speed? We gotta make it to Hush, man. We gotta make it to that portal. We got lucky yesterday and then threw that luck away because, you know, we got rescued by the... That's fine. By the RNG. Still don't know what Tonsil does, by the way. Maybe it might give us extra plays on the blood bank because we're sick. I doubt it. That doesn't make any sense, actually. Kidney bean. Love toots. I don't want kidney bean. If I'm gonna be making a red heart build, then I'm gonna want this yum heart here. Cause when we get this angel room, it's gonna pay out. It's definitely gonna pay out. You know what's gonna pay out with? Sacred Heart. I'm not gonna lie to you, I had a dream last night about Isaac. Because for some reason I dream about Isaac sometimes. Actually, I dream about a lot of things. Dreams are weird. They start shoving things together. Like, that shouldn't even be together, but it happens, and it's weird. But, I had a dream that yesterday, Nick was playing Isaac with his girlfriend, and he walked into an angel room on a Curse of the Blind, and he got Sacred Heart. Now, I don't know why it happened like that, but it did. Don't judge me, because... Oh, yes. Don't judge me. Wait, did we get a tears upgrade? Or have we always been firing this quick? Am I losing my mind? I feel like we're firing quicker now. Maybe not. I think I'm going crazy. Yeah, don't judge me because I dream about this game, okay? You can't control what your mind wants to dream about. You can only really accept it. Then again, we've had this discussion before. You can control what you dream about. It just takes a lot of practice and expertise. You know, now that I know that about Littlehorn or Bighorn, that's not that annoying of a fight anymore. He does kind of telegraph when he's going to be able to be vulnerable to a bomb. But I think that's because they nerfed him, maybe. Ooh, chaos. Alright, hang on here, alright? Don't get me wrong, chaos is great, and I will pick it up, but we should wait. We should definitely wait. Another Joker card. We should definitely wait to pick up chaos. Just so I can see, okay? I might have a premonition here. We're going to get an angel room on this floor. Why, how do I know? Because it's gonna happen. That 50-50 shot at the angel room, it's gonna happen. And when it happens, I wanna see. I mean, we're not on Curse of the Blind. We're just on a normal floor. But I just wanna see. RNGesus usually has these tells when he's gonna deliver his heart to us, man. And give us just the straight legendary run that we ain't had in, like, forever. In fact, I can't even remember the last time we had a legendary run. We haven't even had a run of legend in any recent memory. We haven't had any breaking runs that have actually popped off and let me get infinite items in a while. Not saying that's a terrible thing. That's good that you don't get those that often. Because I feel like every week or so when I was playing Afterbirth or even Rebirth, I would always get blank card Yera at least once a week, if not once every 2 weeks or so. Now, I might be making some bold claims about, you know, being able to get this angel room payout, but it is a 50-50 shot. And if I know anything about 50-50 shots, is that I'm terrible at them. Oh god. And that Mario Party 3's 50-50 shots are a goddamn lie. Yep. Yep. That's what I get. That's what I get. And you know what? Oh, it's so tempting. I don't want to pass up Dark Bum. Because it's Dark Bum. And he curses us if we pass him up. You know what? This is actually stupid. I'm not gonna lie. It's stupid what I'm doing right now. So I am gonna take these. Why is it stupid to what I'm doing? I'm passing up good deals for no reason at that point. Like I said, if you're gonna give me a good deal, I'm not gonna pass you up. You're gonna give me the good deal, then I'll take your good deal, okay? And the thing is, we have chaos. We're about to get chaos. We are so slow though. So with chaos, we will get some Angel Room items. Regardless if the game wants us to have them or not. We're gonna have them. And when we get them, it's gonna be nice. And I also have to avoid the Dark Bum curse. Like, that has actually screwed me in the past. No joke. I'm not joking. That's not something to joke about. The curse of Dark Bum is a very real thing. And if you don't believe it, then go ahead. Pass up Dark Bum on one of your runs. I'm done with Tonsil. I don't know what it does. Okay. I never figured out what it did. So I'm just going to leave it behind for Endless Nameless at the chance of getting Endless Joker cards. That sounds like a pretty good deal to me. Go ahead, Dark Bum. Here you go. I am so slow. Like, legit slow. We are slow time-wise. We're slow speed-wise. We are just slow. I kind of want to pop this Joker card right now. Is it a good idea? Probably not. Am I going to do it? Probably not. And by probably not, I mean more than likely. Why? Why is there a mimic in the cursed room? Why do you do this to me? That was not even worth opening. No. Dark Bum, you weren't supposed to curse me, man. I told you. You're only supposed to curse me if I don't pick you up. On a run to where it would be stupid not to pick you up. And now you're actually You know what? I'll take this. Mama Mega? I'll gladly take this. Why? This is a freebie pass for one floor. You know what that one floor is going to be? Oh, good, because I don't either. I'm glad you know, because I really don't know what I'm going to use this floor for. And you know what? Tell you what. No. No, too late. We're committing. We're committing this Mama Mega play. Why? Because I'm pretty sure it can show up later in the run as well, even if we've already used it on the run before. We're going to commit. We don't need Yum Heart anymore. We really don't. Now, I must say, it's probably going to be very unlikely for us to ever get a speed upgrade ever again with Chaos. But that's not a bad thing, to be honest. Ugh! Because sometimes I feel like it's better for me to have low speed in Isaac. That way I won't overdodge. I don't trust those buttons. Therefore, I will not push them. If I've learned anything from Isaac, is that the buttons are almost always bad. You guys know it. We all know it. Don't judge me. What? What is this room? Since when is there double monster on the depths? It's a really rare room. Like that air room, that doesn't show up all too often. This room, I don't think I've ever seen on the depths. Ever. This run's weird. This is a weird run. And you know what? I'll take it. Because this game is not fun if it's not weird, you know. The funnest runs in Isaac are the ones that get crazy, stupid, weird. And you know, we have a real machine, so I'm gonna go ahead and take advantage of that. The map? No, we don't need the map. Give me some chaos. You know what? I'll take this. This is useful. I don't dare even want to reroll that again, just to see what happens afterwards. I've been in this situation before, where I've restocked the shop on accident or in greed mode just to see it have second heart and then have to scrounge around all day to be able to buy it, or else RNGesus will help hate me forever. It's happened. Oh, Endless Nameless paid out with another strength card. I wonder what the percentage chance is to get another card is. Ow. I know you guys are talking about, I calculated that damage. I actually took that damage on purpose so I can have Smart Fly going. Actually, you know, I probably shouldn't comment on every bit of damage that I take, to be honest. Now I think about it. Wooden Nickel. No. Okay. You know what? Yes. I will buy this. I will buy this just to merely use it and get the four spirit hearts from it. And I will take my Omega and I'm leaving. We didn't get our Joker card back. That's fine. Might as well pick this up. Lord, this run is weird. And you know what? Necropolis is my freebie for. Fuck that. Dry baby. Oh, we can't get the dry baby now. What the hell? Unless I get a ability to fly, we can't get dry baby. Freaking Mama Mega has. Nah, that's fine. We'll get some random other dry baby. Watch. Well, it doesn't work on this room. Oh, we could have walked out, but who needs to walk out? You see that Dipsy Doodles right there? Just that good. Just that good. Luna. Too late to get the boss rush with that. But you know what? I'm just gonna use this. And then pop the moon card. I thought about like endless cards against humanity being a potentially good thing, which it could have been. Maybe I'll time for that right now. And I just dodged his payout. You know what? That's okay. Oh no, I didn't. Perfect. Now, why did I use it on Necropolis? Ow. Why did I use it on Necropolis? Because this floor is a freaking nightmare with no speed. I hate Mask of Infamy so much. I pretty much assumed that we'd run into them and used Mama Mecha. If I wasn't going to use it here, I was going to try and use it on the Void floor. But that's doing too much. It's doing way too much. What is that? Jawbreaker? Use diaper, you stink. What? I'm gonna pop this. Hold this. I don't know what use diaper does. Oh, gotta go to the shop. Gotta at least visit the shop. Even if it's greed. Even if it's greed, man. Gotta visit these shops. There could be anything in here. There could even be a bunch of, you know, poison items. Or bomb items. That for some reason Chaos just loves to deliver. And we are still slow, might I add. We are still very, very slow. And so far this hasn't bitten me in the butt at all. Knock on wood. I have no wood to knock on. Therefore I need you guys. Ooh. We actually don't need this right now, Darbum. We don't need these payouts right now. I'll take that. But I don't need any more payouts. Fine. Oh my. That's some damage. Look at these deeps right now. Oh my god. Wait, how's boss rush open? What? Wait a minute. How's boss rush open in 21 minutes? I'm gonna go for the polar invincibility here. Clearly. But I'm gonna take this. Hey, that's, oh, now it's gone. I guess I had my one shot at boss rush to look in there. And I probably should have. I don't know why boss rush was open at 21 minutes, but it was. I don't know if that's a bug. I don't know if it's because of something we have. Like I said, this run is weird. We can fly now, Dad. It's the whole reason I bought Halo of Flies. Was to potentially trigger Beelzebub. Poison Touch. Do it. Right now. Give me Spun. Make me even stronger. Please. Do it. You had a chance. Chubb dislikes smoke, though. You guys know that? Ooh, Emperor cards. Emperor card! No! Why? Why you do this? You guys, you know, I didn't actually know that this was the name of those, like, laser gut monsters for the longest time. Until I seen the Pokemon Go item call it this. I was wondering what these were called based off of. And now I know. Hey. Hey, we made up time on this floor. Now we got 7 minutes to beat the next floor. And then we reroll our whole run. No? And then we donate? Nah, not today. I need this money. You know what I'm gonna need this money for? It's destiny for Chaos to give us something good. Right now, that Chaos is not giving us anything good. But it will give us something good. It's a matter of time, to be honest. Even if it's on the hush floor, in the hush shop, it's gonna give us something good. That's just like the guarantee when you pick up Chaos, or your money back. Why? Not that I'm mad, but why? Every curse room has a mimic now. I don't understand what is happening. Maybe that's just my luck. Maybe that just goes to show I need to stop going to curse rooms. Maybe Jacob's Ladders actually does that. That's probably an interesting... There's probably an interesting Bible story behind that. That I don't know of. There's a lot of religion backgrounds that this game has, obviously. And if you don't really know, then I'm not really too big of a, you know, religious person, so I don't really know everything about the religion backstories and all that. I don't really pay attention to it. Basically, my thoughts on religion is you can believe in what you want to believe in, dude. As long as you don't try to spread your beliefs upon other people and think you're above other people because you believe in a religion, then, like, that's fine. You know, believe in what you want to believe in. I don't care. I'm friends with atheists. I'm friends with people who are super religious. You know, I don't really mind. You know, we can all coexist. As long as you don't try and, you know, say that someone else is bad because of their choices in life, then you can do what you want to do. You know? Oh, yes. Let's go. I got plenty of keys. And plenty of time. Or you can waste it. Why? You have forsaken me, Hollow Chest. Once again. You do this to me. And we meet again, it lives. You ended my run yesterday. When you shouldn't have ended my run yesterday. Now I'm back for revenge. Yes. Sweet. Savory revenge. No void portal, which means we're fighting Hush. I will not buy the quarter. That's like an old time devil deal right there. Quarter for 3 spirit hearts? I don't think so. Not today. Alright. Chaos is your last chance to show me I didn't pick you up for no reason. You had some... You know, I'll take it actually. You had so much time to show me that you're not useless of picking up. And now you're starting to show me that you are starting to be useless from picking up. Mr. Boom. We don't have a space bar item. At this point, we're looking for that crawl space. That may or may not be down here. Not even that room. Oh my god. Chaos. Are you actually gonna screw me here? Probably should have took the mom item, to be honest. You would. Hey, it seems like you're going to. Mom's razor. Sure. What's this? Two of diamonds?
Two of diamonds.
Oh! Wow. Alright, Judgy. This is the last chance for you to save Chaos's behind here. to show me that it wasn't a useless pickup. You failed me. You've all failed me. What has happened? What is this garbage? I believed in you, Chaos. You're like the last item I enjoyed. Always picking up. And you screwed me. I can't believe you've done this. You've done this to me. I thought we were friends! Okay, this is actually Hush. I actually forgot about that. Apparently there's a 1/4 chance for a blue baby to show up instead of Hush. I got thanks to my friend Daniel for showing me that, because I did not know that at all. I should have recognized that last time. But I think that's a cool cool addition. Because apparently you still get the Hush credit if you kill Blue Baby that way. Which, I mean, I guess it's a little bit, you know, old now. I guess if you got that 1/4 roll, say, on Apollyon, you'd basically get an easy Hush kill, but Hush is not that bad. And see, this is where my low speed comes into advantage. I prefer having low speed for bullet hell fights. For the reason that it lets me make small adjustments to my movement. Which is why back when I did that Toho video when I failed at it, I basically held the focus button down the whole time. Because I like moving slower to make, you know, minuscule adjustments. I feel like dodges are just a lot more simpler to make if I'm moving slower. I don't know if that logic, you know, applies or not, or makes sense or not, but, you know, I don't even know why I'm holding on to the death card. But that's my logic, okay? And what my logic says goes. Wait. What is this behind us? What is this? Wait, where did this come from? Has this tonsil been behind us the whole time? I don't feel like it's been there the whole time. So is that what tonsil's been doing the whole time? Just giving us like this weird Guppy's hairball thing behind us that I have no clue what it does? That's definitely a tonsil. How long has that been there? Cause I'm telling you guys right now, I 100% didn't notice that was there. We have so many orbitals that it's like, I don't feel like I can even be hit right now. Like, we got Smart Fly, we got Halo of Flies, we got Mom's Razor, and we got this tonsil thing that I don't know if it blocks shots or not. But I feel like it has been. Oh, that's what I get. It looks like it blocks shots. I mean, I'm not saying it doesn't block shots. And if it does, then, you know, more power to me. Get in there, Smart Fly. Do your thing, man. We lose an orbital, but that's okay. I'm gonna need you to stay popped up, please, Hush. So I can actually attack you. It'd be nice. Please. Please stop. Yes, just stay right there. Also, apparently bleed makes things take a percentage of their max health and damage over a period of time, I think is what that I read on that post. So bleed is actually a really good status effect, but I don't think it works against bosses, so that's unfortunate, because that would be so good. But you guys know how good percentage damage is in certain games, specifically MOBAs. Could you imagine that though? Being able to deal maximum percentage health damage against bosses in this game. We would just obliterate Hush in no time at all. Wait, we should go buy that Spirit Heart from the shop. We're going so slow. Why not take the HP, Dan? Well, it should be obvious why we're not taking the HP. For the fact of the matter is, the Polaroid invincibility is going to help us. Why take Mr. Boom? Just thought about that. No reason to take that. Sure, we have no bombs, but bombs are gonna be bar none useless now. So I should be leaving now. Hello? Can I go? Hello? Am I not allowed to go? About to say. Alrighty. Let's do this. Welcome to the void. That's the best I can get right now. It's too early to try any like super voices or super weird voices right now. It's not without my voice changer. I'm gonna need that. I actually have another free writing story I wanna write soon. Definitely one that's been relatable to things that's going on lately. Not in life, but just in general. I actually don't even want to mention what's been going on in life lately. It's just been showing me that the freaking human world is terrible. And that people are capable of doing stupid things for stupid reasons, and it's just sad. It's very, very sad. Still don't know what the crown enemies do. Wish I knew. I have no clue what those do. If anyone knows what those enemies with crowns over them do, let me know in the comments section. Because I have no clue. Hey, what up, Gish? I'm saving this blank room. In the off chance it's outages, I'm using the delirium fight. I'm gonna have like endless nameless go for endless times. Cause there's already a chance that a blank rune can drop when you use a blank rune. But what are the chances of endless nameless giving you another blank rune when you use the blank rune, and then the blank rune giving you another blank rune? So you have a chance at double blank runes when you use the blank rune. You get what I mean? You know, I put your blank rune in your blank room. Oh god. Wait, what? You see that? Why'd he stop like that? Why's he stop like that? Is this champion cage that never jumps? I'm fine with that. Ooh, let's go. So many bomb items. Not enough time. Delirium down here? Really, it'd be real nice if he was down here. Nope. It's definitely not delirium. You know, that's okay. I mean, we're just adding more forms to delirium's final form, but you know. It's fine. We're fine. Contra from below? Boss music didn't stop playing for some odd reason. Only just, you know, just another day in the Isaac world. Just another day in the Isaac world. I might even be overestimating Jacob's ladders, because the damage from the lasers don't seem to be that good. But I don't care. I just like it because it looks cool. And it's amazing tier effect. Oh, and Curse of the Tower freaking sad bombs with Jacob's ladders just looks amazing. Come on, that's straight up eye candy, dude. If this item is anything, it's straight up eye candy. And I love it. You guys know how much I just... Oh, a void. Now, what happens if you use the black rune in the void? You just straight up die? You cancel the game out? I'm kind of scared. For no reason. I mean, that feels like the world would explode if you actually try to use that, right? Oh, hi. Hello, friend. Rune bag. A little bit late for rune bag, but come on along. I've actually not seen Void do anything other than delete enemies. Apparently it deletes more than just the enemies. It can delete pickups on the ground too. But I still don't know if this will actually do something. Which is why I'm very reluctant to use it right now. But if someone doesn't do it, then who else will? Because sometimes you gotta push the limit of Isaac in order to see what the game is actually capable of. Know what I mean? 9 volt. Gives us 2 of diamonds. Alright then. Who dares wins is all I got to say. Even if somehow using Void in the Void insta-kills you and makes you instantly lose your run, I would want to see it happen. Because I like to see the world burn sometimes. Well, I'll tell you what. This is probably not the Delirium fight. It's probably the one all the way up there. Now that I look at it. I mean, there's one above us and there's one all the way at the top of the map on its lonesome. That one has to be Delirium up there. It's not this one. There's no way it's this one. A new pill has appeared! Wait, what? Sim Collector? What? What just happened? What? A new pill has appeared. We can't even see pills on this run. I kinda wanna take... We don't need the stars card, there's no reason. There's no items on the floor. It's definitely the one way up there, which means we got a long trip. So I hope you guys are buckled in. It's gonna be a long walk. I mean, we might as well check out that other boss fight too. Wait, I don't want the pills. I want Book of Sin. On the off chance we are able to get any Joker cards. Alright then. Yep, gonna be a long trip with this low ass speed. Still don't know what the Sin Collector means. Because to be honest, I didn't see what that achievement was for. I should probably look it up after we finish the run on the Steam. See what it says. Because we didn't pick up anything, right? We just kind of got it. Out of nowhere. Yeah, can we just void this room? It didn't do anything. It did nothing. Unfortunately, the world didn't explode. Nothing happened. When I used the void in the void. That's boring. I was hoping something would explode. Things did not explode. I'm unhappy. Yeah, please be Delirium so we don't have to walk across the whole map. Please? Please? Now, how does this work with this? Does the lasers go anywhere? Nope, it's the same. God damn it. It's not Delirium. Which means we have to walk all the way up there. Oh, but the wafer. It's been worth it. Wow. The wafer with the life-saving plays. Which, I mean, we didn't really need damage resistance, but there's no way to lose this run now. We'd have to take... Was it 24 hits to die now? That's not happening. Anytime soon. And I think we might have Chaos to thank for that. It took its sweet time, but Chaos actually did something. Uh-oh. And you know what? That's okay. Chaos. I ain't even gonna blame you. I'm not blaming you. You took your time. And even if it wasn't Chaos's fault for giving us... I'm actually just gonna take the Empress card over Magician. In case Endless Nameless works, we can just stack them up infinitely. Oh, Alges. Well, we got Alges anyway, so You don't even need blank room now. That was like part throw or something. Yeah, I'm just gonna take the safe way out here. Even though we don't need it, we have... You know what? I do want to take the blank rune. I have to. I have my commitment to being able to see if we just have endless blank runes. Like just what just happened there a while ago. Therefore, I'm going to use it. I can't build something up and then not do it at the end. And then we gotta get out a jail free card, which... No reason for that. Give. We'll take blank rune and we'll take Empress. Here we go. And it doesn't work. What was this? It was nothing. It didn't do anything. Hey, stack these Empresses. We got two Empresses. Pretty substantial damage boost. Wait, what? Oh god, what the fuck? Yo, some of these forms. I don't know if I agree with some of these forms sometimes. It'd be really hard to dodge. I love this music though. Dude, Isaac has such good music. I have, oh, a justice card. Where'd this come from? Another justice card. Which then gives us another justice card. Which then gives us another justice card. Which still what? Why didn't we have this with freaking Empress? Hello? Oh god, what? Oh, that looks so cool. I want to get hit more often just to see that. Like, he telefrags you so hard. This is going to be ridiculous with the loss. I'm just saying. The telefrags make it almost impossible to not get hit during this fight. If he didn't teleport on top of you, it wouldn't be that bad. But he does that. A lot. Or he tries to teleport behind you. Which I guess you could always, you know, stand near a wall, but that really wouldn't help either. I'm just complaining. We're gonna win. Oh my god. Yes, oh, yep, right there. Did you see that? He telefried and then jumped. I almost didn't dodge that. Almost. Okay, he's breaking Monster 2's freaking animations over there. What the fuck? Calm down. Jesus. Apparently this guy's immune to Chaos card too. Which is unfortunate. But hell, you don't even get Chaos card anymore. That card doesn't even exist. Dude, slow down. Holy crap. Calm down. What? How the... What? You guys saw that, right? He's so fast, he just teleports on top. What the... There's no way. There's no way this is getting done with Keeper or Lost. What the fuck? Ain't no goddamn way. Ain't no way. No way. We've unlocked the Eucharist. Which, what I've heard, is the goat head equivalent of Angel Rooms, which I'll take it. That was actually spoiled in the post before AFTERBIRTH Plus came out. Well then, man, that Delirium fight still gets pretty hectic at times. But I hope you guys enjoyed the run today. If you did, please leave a like at the top of the ton. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't, because I always do more Let's Plays and game videos every single day. But thanks for your time. Thank you for support. Thanks for watching. See you guys next time. Some more Isaac, some more videos. See you then.